الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأصلي وأسلم على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد وإنا وكتاب منظومة الآداب لابن عبد القوي المرداوي رحمه الله. We reached the line in which the Shaykh rahimahullah he said, وَأَوْجِبْ عَنِ الْمَحْظُورِ كَفَّ جَوَارِحٍ وَنَدْبٌ عَنِ الْمَكْرُوهِ غَيْرُ مُشَدَّدِ. Previously what we spoke about is the limbs and to safeguard your limbs. And here the Shaykh rahimahullah, he's speaking about the limbs in general, because previously he was speaking about it in particular, the tongue, the eye, but now he's actually speaking in general. So the Shaykh is here telling us to stay away from the prohibited things. Stay away from the prohibited things. Such as stealing, to stay away from anger, stay away from killing, stay away from backbiting, staying away from cursing, stay away from committing zina, all of that. That the person, he abstains from all of that. ولذلك, the Shaykh also elaborated on staying away from the disliked things. Because that's also good that you withhold from it. He said, وَأَوْجِبْ عَنِ الْمَحْظُورِ كَفَّ جَوَارِحٍ. Stay away from the prohibited things and safeguard, hold back your limbs. وَنَدْبٌ عَنِ الْمَكْرُوهِ غَيْرُ مُشَدَّدِ. And it's also highly recommended that you leave off the disliked things غَيْرَ مُشَدَّدِ, but not in a forceful manner. It's recommended, it's disliked. الأداب الوسطى. It's mentioned there. ويجب كف يده. It is obligatory that the person hold his hand. وفمه and his mouth. وفرجه and his private part. وبقية أعضائه and the remaining part of his limbs. عما يحرم from those things which are prohibited. ويسن عما يكره. And it is recommended to stay away from that which is disliked. Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he mentions, he says, وَهَذَا فِي مَنْ لَمْ يَضُرَّ إِلَىٰ ذَٰلِكَ وَإِلَّا جَازَ. This is talking about a person who necessity has not forced him to do it. Because that person is permissible for him. Some things which are prohibited, they become permissible under necessity. We're not talking about necessity here. Then the author, rahimahullah, he said, وَأَمْرَكَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهْيِ يَا أَفَتَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ جَعَلْ فَرْضَ عَيْنِي تُسَدَّدِي عَلَى عَالِمٍ بالحذر والفعل لم يقم سواه به مع أمن عدوان معتدي ولو كان ذا فسق وجهل وفي السواء الذي قيل فرض بالكفاية وحددي. The Shaykh rahimahullah, here he's talking about calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. He said, وَأَمْرَكَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهْيِ يَا فَتَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ جَعَلْ فَرْضَ عَيْنُ تُسَدَّدِي. Calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. The Sheikh tells us here, so what does Ma'ruf festival mean in the Arabic language? Ma'ruf is anything that the Sharia commanded. Mimma yu'maru bihi shar'a. It is anything that is ordered by the Sharia. And munkar means ma yunha anhu shar'a. Anything that is prohibited from it shar'an in the Sharia. Al-amru bil ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkar is wajib. Fardain. As our overall ruling. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, Kuntum you are خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. سورة آل عمران آية 10. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى He said in سورة آل عمران آية 104, which is on the other side of the page. He said ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر. And He also said سبحانه وتعالى لعن الذين كفروا من بني إسرائيل على لسان داود وعيسى بن مريم ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه لبئس ما كانوا يفعلون. سورة المائدة آية 8 آية 78 آية 78. In that ayah, Allah says that the disbelievers are cursed. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The disbelievers are cursed. From the children of Israel. On the tongue of who? عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ. On the tongue of Nabiullah Dawood. And also on the tongue of عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا. And the reason for that is because they disobeyed their Lord. وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. And they transgressed, they exceeded their limits. كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهُونَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ. They never prohibited one another from an evil that one did. They didn't. Allah then says, لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. What an evil thing which they did. What an evil thing in which they did. Also the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, as Imam al-Tirmidhi, he narrated in his Sunan or in his Jami' عن حذيفة, that حذيفة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال, that حذيفة said, والذي نفسي بيده, I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand, لتأمرن بالمعروف, you will call to the good, ولتنهون عن المنكر, and you will prohibit the evil, أو ليوشكن الله أن يبعث عليكم عقابا منه ثم تدعونه فلا يستجاب لكم. Or Allah will bring out from you a punishment. ثم تدعونه, then you will try to supplicate to him. فلا يستجاب لكم, and your dua will be accepted. You make dua and no one's dua will be accepted. And also in another hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, you will call to the good. وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and you will prohibit the evil. أَوْ لَيُسَلِّطَنَّ اللَّهُ شِرَارَكُمْ عَلَى خِيَارِكُمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَوْ لَيُسَلِّطَنَّ اللَّهُ شِرَارَكُمْ عَلَى خِيَارِكُمْ فَيَدْعُوا خِيَارُكُمْ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُمْ. You will call to the good and you will prohibit the evil. Or Allah will place over you the evilest ones amongst you. And they will govern and control the righteous ones. Then the righteous ones will make dua, فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُمْ, and their dua will not be accepted. Also the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ قَوْمٍ, there is not a people, فِيهِمْ رَجُلٌ يَعْمَلُ بِالْمَعَاصِ, there is not a group of people, or there is not a nation, or there is not a people, in which amongst them A man commits sins. وَهُمْ أَعَزُّ مِنْهُ And they are more stronger than him. وَأَمْنَعْ And they can prevent him. They can stop him. لَا يُغَيِّرُوا And they choose not to change the matter. إِلَّا أَصَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِعِقَابٍ Except Allah will afflict them with a punishment. Except Allah will what? He will afflict them with a punishment. وَقَالَ مِسْعَرْ مِسْعَرْ He said, أُمِرَ مَلَكٌ أَن يَخْسِفَ بِقَرْيَةٍ أُمِرَ مَلَكٌ An angel was ordered أَن يَخْسِفَ بِقَرْيَةٍ To destroy a village or a town. فَقَالَ The angel said, يَا رَبِّ My Lord, فِيهَا فُلَانٌ الْعَابِدٌ So and so, who is a worshipper, is amongst them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the angel, فَأَوْحَى اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ أَن بِهِ فَابْدَأ Allah said to the angel, start with him. Why? فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَتَمَعَّرْ وَجْهُهُ فِي يَسَعَ The reason is because his face لَمْ يَتَمَعَّرْ لَمْ يَتَمَعَّرْ means what? When the person becomes angry, what happens to their face? They go like this. They scold. They get angry. Yeah? That person, his evil act, sorry, this righteous servant, sorry, who's a worshipper, he never got angry for the sake of Allah. فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَتَمَعَّرْ وَجْهُ فِي يَسَاعَ لَمْ يَتَمَعَّرْ here means سَكِنَايَةٌ عَنِ الْغَضَبِ It means that he never got angry for my sake. لِأَنَّ the mu'min, the believer, if Allah's حُرُمَات إِذَا هُتِكَ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ If Allah تبارك وتعالى's sacred legislations are being disobeyed, the believer's heart cannot, what? He cannot hold himself together. ولذلك عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said what? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم He never used to give victory for his own self. Somebody did something to him, he'll forgive. But if somebody did something to Allah and his religion, The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will get angry for it. And the ahadiths that have come regarding this are immense and they are extensive. Regarding what? Al-amru bil ma'roof wa nahya anil munkar. And I want you to always remember this. Wallahi, if it wasn't for amru bil ma'roof, and if it wasn't for an-nahyu anil munkar, If it was not, ولولا الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر ها لشاع الجهل Ignorance would have spread. وبطل العلم And knowledge would nullify. And you see on the pulpits the زنادقة give the khutbah. You see the what? شرار خلق الله The evilest, the worst people on the face of this earth will be given khutabs, the Friday sermon. And the Amr bil Ma'ruf and Nahi anil Munkar, it is what gets rid of ignorance and it is what makes knowledge prevail. Al Amr bil Ma'ruf, brothers and sisters. فرض على كل مسلم It is obligatory on every Muslim لا يسقط في حال من الأحوال It will never be uplifted from you الأمر بمعروف عن المنكر It never gets uplifted from you And the person is always able to reject the evil and to accept the good on the different levels that the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. So that's why it's always obligatory on you, and you will either fall in one of these categories. مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ You stop it with your hand. Any one of you who sees evil, stop it with your hand. فإن لم يستطع, if you're not able, فبلسانه, your tongue, فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه, if you can't do it with your tongue, then do it with your heart. فإن من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيدي, فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه, فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه, وذلك أضعف الإيمان, and that is the weakest branch of iman. And because of that, فَلَا يَجُوزُ, it is never permissible for you. So it can happen that you may not be able to physically stop it. And it may happen sometimes you may not even be able to say it. Okay? You might not even be able to say it. But what you can never escape from, which you have to come with, is your heart. Your heart has to reject the evil and to accept the good, and it is not permissible for you, أَيَرْضَى بِالْمَعْصِيَةِ, to ever be happy with a sin and a crime that is being done. وَلَوْ لَمْ يَقْدِرْ عَلَى إِزَالَتِهَا, it doesn't even matter if you can't stop this evil. It doesn't matter if you don't have the ability to eradicate and get rid of this evil. لِذَلِكَ, that's why Ibn Abi Dunya, Ibn Abi Dunya, he has in his Mawsu'ah, he has a kitab called Kitab al-Amr bil-Ma'ruf wa Nahy al-Munkar. All the narrations that have come from it, from his own chain of narration, he speaks about it. Rahimahullah, Ibn Abi Dunya. He brought in his book a hadith from Abu Hurairah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ حَضَرَ مَعْصِيَةً, anyone who is present in a place where sins are being done, فَكَرِهَهَا, and he dislikes it. Whilst he's there, but he dislikes it. فَكَأَنَّهُ غَابَ عَنْهَا, it is like he was absent from that gathering. وَمَنْ غَابَ عَنْهَا, and anyone who is absent from a gathering which evil is being done, but he loves it, فَأَحَبَّهَا فَكَأَنَّهُ حَضَرَهَا, it is like as though he was one who was participating in it. So as I said before, الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر إن فرض على كل مسلم لا يسقط في حال من الأحوال, it will never be uplifted from you. And based on the statement of the author here, he mentions that, which is what, وأمرك بالمعروف والنهي يا فتى عن المنكر اجعل فرض عين, it is a فرض عين, it is a individual obligation to call to the good and to prohibit the evil. So that's what we take from the statement of the author, rahimahullah. Now, we want to know something. If a person is scared, and he fears for himself, what does he do? And I just touched on it just a minute ago. What gets lifted from him is the first part of al-amr bil-ma'ruf wa al-munkar, which is to physically stop it. Fear comes. The a'imma Ibn Rajab rahimahullah, Ibn Rajab in his kitab Jami' al-Ulum al-Hikam, he says, وَقَدْ نَصَّ الْأَئِمَّةُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ مِنْهُمْ مَالِكٌ وَأَحْمَدُ وَإِسْحَاقُ وَغَيْرُهُمْ. That Imam Ahmed and Ishaq ibn Rahuya and Imam Malik before them, there's clear statements of theirs, which is what? The أَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهِي عَلِي الْمُنْكَرِ is lifted from your shoulders if the person is scared. That falls under فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ, if he's not able. Fear is فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ, if you're scared, then it can't be lifted from you. But what can't be lifted from you, and these noble a'imma are not referring to what's in your heart, meaning if you physically fear, if you stop something, and if you physically fear that if you speak, then it can fall under the one who is unable to do so. That is a statement of Imam Malik, Imam Ahmed, and Ishaq, and other than them. Ibn Shubruma, He said al-amru bil ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkari kal jihad. Like jihad. Calling to the good and prohibiting the evil is a jihad. It's like jihad. يجب على الواحد أن يصابر فيه الاثنين ويحرم عليه الفرار منهما ولا يجب عليه مصابرة أكثر من ذلك. Ibn Shubrumha, he said it is obligatory on one person to be patient with two people. In a battlefield, how many people can you fight with? Two. He said, if you are calling to the good and prohibiting the evil, and they are two people and you're scared of them, up to two, you have to be patient, you're not allowed to run. But if it's more than two, he said, وَيَحْرُمُ عَلَيْهِ الْفِرَارُ مِنْهُمَا وَلَا يَجِبُ عَلَى عَلَيْهِ الْمُصَابَرَةُ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. But if it's more than two, then it's not upon you. You can stay away from doing it. What about if a person fears insult? فَإِنْ خَافَ السَّبِّ أَوْ إِسْمَاعِ الْكَلَامِ السَّيِّئِ لَمْ يَسْقُطْ عَنُهُ الْإِنْكَارُ لِذَلِكَ. The person is what? If a person fears insult, name calling, people are going to call me names if I say this. If I prohibit the evil from this, the people are going to call me bad names. They're going to, you know, ridicule me. I'm going to be shown in an evil light. Yeah? Then we say to this, لَمْ يَسْقُطْ عَنْهُ الْإِنْكَارُ بِذَلِكَ. For you, the ruling is not lifted from you. You still have to do al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkar. And Imam Ahmed said that, rahimahullah. Are you with me? When Imam Ahmed said that, it was then said to him, Imam Ahmed clearly said that, in khafa sab, if a person fears to be insulted, he fears Isma'u al-Kalam al-Sayyi, or somebody's going to make him hear evil speech that he doesn't like to hear, somebody's going to call him names, then Imam Ahmad said it is not permissible for him to stay away from calling to the good. He still has to do it. Then Imam Ahmad was reminded of the hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ said, لَيْسَ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ أَن يُذِلَّ نَفْسَهُ. It is not befitting for a believer to humiliate himself. Then the Sahabas asked, Ya Rasulullah, wa kayfa yudhillu nafsahu? How would one humiliate himself? The Prophet said, and yu'arridaha, he presents himself, min al-bala'i, he presents himself to a problem, lima la taqata lahu bihi, which he has no ability for. They said, Imam Ahmad, how can you say that he has to still call to the good and prohibit the evil when there's this hadith? Imam Ahmad said, laysa hadha min dhak. This hadith is not talking about that. This hadith is not talking about that. And what strengthens Imam Ahmad's speech is the hadith in which Abu Dawood, Ibn Majah, At-Tirmidhi, they narrated on the authority of Abi Sa'id that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَفْضَلُ الْجِهَادِ, the best form of jihad, is كَلِمَةُ عَدْلٍ عِنْدَ سُلْطَانٍ جَائِرٍ. It is saying speech of justice, speech of truth in the presence of a tyrant leader. Next to him, you say it. Imam Ahmad, Abu Dawood, and Tirmidhi ibn Majah narrated it. Now listen to this. You know the leader. He's a tyrant leader. And you know he's going to deal with you in a very severe way. Yeah? ولذلك بزار, he narrated in his Musnad. Huh? He narrated in his Musnad, which is called Al-Bahru Zakhir. أما البحر, it's called Al-Bahru Zakhar. Naam. In the chain of narration, there's a Jahala, somebody who is unknown. On the authority of Abi Ubaidah, Amr ibn Jarrah, he said, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, I said to the Messenger of Allah, أَيُّ الشُّهَدَاءِ أَكْرَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, which of the martyrs are most beloved to Allah? Which is the greatest form of a martyr? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رَجُلٌ أَيْمَانٌ قَامَ إِلَىٰ إِمَامٍ جَائِرٍ فَأَمَرَهُ بِمَعْرُوفٍ وَنَهَاهُ ونهاه عن منكر فقتله. A man who stood up to a leader who is a tyrant leader, and he called him to the good, and he prohibited him from the evil, and he got killed because of that. Ibn al-Jawzi, he said, فَأَمَّا السَّبُّ, as for name calling, وَالشَّتْمُ, an insult, فَلَيْسَ بِعُذْرٍ فِي السُّكُوتِ, it is not an excuse for one to be silent. Just because you're going to be called names or you're going to be insulted, it's not an excuse, it is not a reason, a justified reason, a legitimate reason for one to be silent and not called to the good and prohibit the evil. Why is that? Ibn al-Jawzi said, لِأَنَّ الْآمِرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ يَلْقَى ذَلِكَ فِي الْغَالِبِ, because the one who is calling to the good, the majority of the time, that's what's going to happen to him anyways. That people are, those who are inclined to that desire, and those who are inclined to this evil act, they will continuously want to carry on doing this evil, and so they're always going to insult you, call, give you evil, bad names. So that's going to happen regardless. ولذلك إمام أبو داود السجستاني رحمه الله صاحب السنن, the author of السنن, he has a book which is مسائل أبي داود لإمام أحمد. أبي داود, there's questions he put to إمام أحمد and he asked them, and it's مطبوع, it's published. Questions that he asked Imam Ahmad, and Imam Ahmad answers those questions. Imam Ahmad said to, sorry, Abu Dawood said to Imam Ahmad, Yushtamu, a person is insulted after calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. Imam Ahmad said, Yahtamilu man yuridu annahu ya'muru aw yanha wa la yuridu an yantasira ba'da dhalik. He would have to, Yahtamilu meaning, he will have to carry the burden. He will have to take that on. You see? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said, As-sabru ala adai al-khalqi inda al-amri bil-ma'rufi wal-nahi anil munkar in lam yusta'mal lazima ahadu al-amrayni imma ta'tilu al-amri wal-nahi wa imma husulu fitnatin wa mafsadatin a'zama min mafsadati tarki al-amri wal-nahi أو مثلها أو قريب منها وكلاهما معصية وفساد. قال الله تعالى وأمر بالمعروف وانهى عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك إن ذلك من عزم الأمور. فمن أمر ولم يصبر أو صبر ولم يأمر أو لم يأمر ولم يصبر حصل من هذه الأقسام الثلاثة مفسدة. وإنما الصلاح في أن يأمر ويصبر. Ibn Taymiyyah said something very powerful. He said, الصبر, patience, على أذى الخلق, in the harming of the creation. الصبر, to be patient, على أذى, the harm of the creation, when calling to what? عند الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. When calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. Ibn Taymiyyah said, if that is not used, إِلَّمْ يُسْتَعْمَلْ, if it's not used, meaning patience is not used, لَزِمَ أَحَدُ أَمْرَيْنِ, one of two problems will come out of it. And if a person does not use patience when calling to the good and prohibiting the evil, patience from what? From the harm of the people. If he doesn't do it, Ibn Taymiyyah said one of two things happens. One, إِمَّا تَعْطِيلُ الْأَمْرِ وَالنَّهِي, either the dismantling of the command and the prohibition. That's going to occur. Dismantling of the commands and the prohibitions. وَإِمَّا أَوْ حُصُولُ فِتْنَةٍ وَمَفْسَدَةٍ أَعْظَمَ مِنْ مَفْسَدَةِ تَرْكِ الْأَمْرِ وَالنَّهِي. Or the fitna, the trials and the tribulation and the corruption which will occur, حُصُولُ, that you will gain, is greater than the corruption of leaving according to the good and prohibiting the evil.
or even equal to it, or even close to it. And all of those two are a sin and corruption. And he said, because of that, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said to us, وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ call to the good. وَنْهَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ and prohibit the evil. وَاصْبِرْ be patient. عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ be patient on that which afflicts you. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ that is the strongest of the matter. فَمَنْ أَمَرَ Ibn Taymiyyah said, anyone who orders the good, وَلَمْ يَسْبِرْ and does not show patience, or صَبَرَ or he shows patience, وَلَمْ يَأْمُرْ but he doesn't order, أو لَمْ يَأْمُرْ or he does not order, وَلَمْ يَصْبِرْ and he doesn't show patience, حَصَلَ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَقْسَامِ ثَلَاثَةِ مَفْسَدَ from those three that I mentioned, corruption will come out of it. وَإِنَّمَا الصَّلَاحُ good and prosperity is in what? في أن يأمر ويصبر. For the one to order and to be patient. Now the question that also comes into place is that when you're calling to the good and you're prohibiting the evil, do you have to hope that what you're trying to say will reach the masses? Or, in better terms, or in better wordings, is it permissible, or is it a condition, for you to call to the good and to prohibit the evil, that you have a high assumption that the evil you're prohibiting will remove and it will go, and the good that you are trying to put forward will be taken? Is there a condition for you to call to the evil, good and prohibit the evil? This is a question that is very important. So I want to call to the good, and I also want to prohibit the evil. Do I have to know that this command in which I'm going to call to, and this evil which I'm going to prohibit, that is going to be taken, it's going to be accepted? Is that a condition? We'll leave that for next lesson, inshallah ta'ala. We'll stop here. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.